so that you know that all the work we do up here, we'll take a picture of it and we're going to put it onto a PowerPoint presentation for you to see if you don't get it. This will all be on one central document. We'll have a listing link there. And this is going to be sort of our learning block. Thank you, Mr. Goodman, for the idea. And all of them will be dated and you just have a link to it. And if you need help, you can just see the picture of all our submissions that we've done up here.
And on your GCSE video, we're going to be talking about probability. Probability is the chances of having an event or the outcome of an event. An event could be, for example, having heads or tails on the coin. Now you know that the chances of getting heads are 50% because you either get a head or a tail. So they both are split between 2. 1 divided by 2, 0.5 or a half. Speaking of which, just to quickly mention, probability, you should know this, but probability is all total 1. Also, whatever you choose aside probability, or it's called the sample space. The example I'm going to take you through today is having different sized colored snooker balls. So, you have, for example, 2 red balls, 3 blue balls, and 4 black balls. Like I said to you, the sample space is everything enclosed inside the area that you can pick. This is, for example, a bag, not a snooker, but it's kind of like that. Now, that bag has 9 balls, so everything inside that bag is a sample space. That's just a good definition. We can also ask, we can have a question for example, and this question quite often comes up in anything that you find. It's if we took 1 red ball, I'm just going to get the red just to show you what I mean. We try to get 1 red. 1 red ball comes out of that bag. The key word here is that it's replaced. Now, you might think that's not really significant. Later on, we're going to show why that is really quite an important key word in the question. Now, back to this. You have 1 red ball, you've just taken it out of the bag, you've seen it, you've noted it down, and you put it back in. That's replaced. Now, you're going to choose 1 black ball. Probability of these events occurring in that order. Actually, because it's quite confusing for some of you. I'm just going to do one. Now, what's the probability of getting a red? That's how you solve a question. When you get a question saying that two different events happen, you have to separate those events into two. You have to find out the probability of each thing happening separately. You know that the 1 red, there's a possible 9 combinations. Out of those, there are only 2 red balls. So the chances of getting 2 red balls out of 9 total balls is 2 out of 9. Write that as a fraction. 2 out of 9. And if you repeat that, you can say that that is the probability of getting the red. Later on, the more professional way of saying it is if you say P of R. But you're not really at that level. Now, the probability of getting a black ball, same thing. You know that you have 9 balls in the bag. And you know that you can only choose 4 black balls out of the total. 4 out of 9. So, 4 out of the probability of getting a black ball, P over, let's say, B. Is 4 out of 9. Now, it's replaced. The significance of it being replaced is that the total always stays the same. So how do you find the answer? Well, you combine the fact that one event happens after another. So you know that the event of getting a red ball is 2 out of 9. But to find the event of getting a red and a black ball, it's actually 2 9 multiplied by whatever comes next. In this case, it's 2 9 multiplied by the 4 9s we calculated earlier. Sometimes students get this wrong by thinking it's an add. It's an addition sum. It can't be an addition sum because the fact that the probability is total 1. Now, I know that this doesn't total 1 because it's 6 over 9, sometimes if the probability of this was 7/9 or greater, then it would be something like 1 and 1/9 or more, and that wouldn't make sense. So actually what happens is that it's multiplied. When we go to tree diagrams, you can see a bit more of how this works. But for now, we're just going to say that you get from one event and find the other, we're just going to multiply. Very simple. 2 times 4 is 8. What did you know that? A nine squared, square numbers, 89. 8 out of 81, that's the probability of getting a red and a black. Some of you might be asking, well, what happens if I wanted to find red or black in any order? Very simple question. Well, to think that through, what you have to think of is that to get this event in reverse is the same thing. Black and red is 4 9 multiplied by 2 9, which is 8 out of 81. So to get red or black in any order, it's just times by 2. So 8 out of 81 times 2, which is 16 out of 81. But that, however, is in any order. You have to remember in any question that you see, you have to see what the question actually asks. Sometimes it may ask you in the specific order, for which case you would do this. But if it says to you in any order, then you have to do this sum. But primarily, this is the first thing you have to do. Now, just to state, what we're actually trying to say is that we're trying to say the probability of getting a red ball, taking it out, noting it down, say this is a red ball, putting it down, putting it back into the bag, and then picking a black ball. That's what we're trying to find out. It's a probability. It's a chance of this event happening, this chance of getting a red ball, putting it in the bag, recording it, and like I said, getting a black ball. No, we haven't included the blue ball because it's not part of our probability. So you'd have to take into consideration the total number of balls, but you don't have to figure out the probability of a blue ball or if prior to answering the question. You can just look at 2 9s and 4 9s and you can use that to solve the question.
Thanks for watching. Please hit the like button, subscribe, and could you please comment down below to let us know which topics you would like us to cover next? It really helps.